If you're wondering who's a better paint does a better paint job, here's his pre-coated, tacky, cured for like a month paint job, right? Ignore my messy stuff, we got a garage sale. Here's my non-tacky, smooth, lasting tan, and this is a BB gun. Now what I like about this BB gun, yeah, I'm missing a rail. It's a BB gun, I took that rail off, and put it on this 22 here. Yeah, I took the flashlight, ignore it. But here on this BB gun, it's about 200 bucks, and I don't have to spend ammo on, I don't have to spend money on 5.56 ammo. I can train with BBs in my backyard or in the country or whatever. Save ammo, get my firearm skills down. I didn't paint this. If you didn't see my last video, the Rossi 22. It's basically an inexpensive 1022, but I went ahead and screwed these rails in and then duct taped the flashlight because I was fucking lazy. It's got a little green dot on there. Pop that on for you. And I got a 12 gauge shotgun somewhere in here. It's got a little green dot. That is loaded too. That's kind of my secondary rifle, bedside rifle. So those two, I painted that one, got that one painted. And I'm like, I have two tan guns. I have a black rifle and I got a black shotgun. Why don't we go ahead and make this fucker olive and black? If you're wondering what I got a white, the classic white rag. I got some medical gloves just in case. Rubbing alcohol, cotton swabs, a level for my scope. I don't think this is gonna do anything. I need to get some graffiti gone, but WD-40, just in case, rim oil, tools, needle nose pliers, basically. Tons of fucking, oh. We got a shop rags, pliers, and needle nose titles. Pliers and flathead screwdrivers, excuse me. Listen to a psychosocial and some Allen keys. You never know what you're gonna fucking need, so just better have it not need it. More rubbing alcohol. Even though I'm painting over it, I'm gonna sand it, dump a little rubbing alcohol, and then paint the front handguard green. Wow. All right, so we got the BCG out. I'll show you here in a second. So we got the handguard off. It's pretty fucking easy. Got the BCG out. We're gonna put a piece of tape up here and we're gonna tape the trigger. Tape the magwell. I don't know how I'm gonna get all this paint out of here. I mean, there's a way to get it out. I just really, I don't like that. At the very least, we'll sand this out. This close up. And for those of you who are wondering, we're gonna tape a couple rounds up here. I get companion tape. You wanna know how to take a buttstock off an AR? It's pretty simple. You just do this, you just bend it forward, comes right off. I do not know if it's commercial or mil-spec. I'm assuming mil-spec just because of how rounded it is. But we're gonna measure that later on just so I can tell what kind of buttstock I wanna get. That's off though. Definitely tape up here a little bit. This gasket's loose, like I said. So I kinda just turn it to this way. So yeah, we're gonna get to sanding and painting and taping. Now all I have is these sheets, and I know I look like an emo kid from like 1994. Holy shit. All right. So the best thing we gotta do here, all I got is fine sand, like really thick sandpaper. So I'm gonna scrub light. You just want something to grab, the glue to grab to. Not glue, the paint to grab to, fuck. Want something for the paint to grab through, damn it. All right, you're just gonna rub it all the way down, the whole damn thing. Not too rough, not too light. The whole damn thing.
And this is how it's taut. And this is what I'll keep continue to do. And as I'm rubbing it, I can smell the paint coming off too. Oh, look at that. It's already gonna, it's gonna come off by just sanding it. Do that, you'll be good. I'm gonna finish sanding this, and then we're gonna dump some alcohol, rubbing alcohol on it. You want 70 proof rubbing alcohol. Wire it, I'm gonna show you painting it. And then we're gonna tape that up. You can't even see, we're gonna tape the rest of the rifle up and we're gonna paint that. But first we gotta take the grip off. So now that I got it sanded, you can even see some of the paint coming off, especially like on the rail here, the original black. It smells like straight fucking spray paint, but, oh, shit, I keep ripping my jeans. Yeah, I'm wearing the fucking ripped Ariats today. Just don't want to get my nice jeans all painty.
I was going to thread it all the way in, and I decided to just do these two holes just because fuck it. It's off the ground. We're going to go ahead and dump rubbing alcohol on that, and we're going to paint that. Taped up, taped the magwell, trigger, the grip, the buffer tube, and then the little hole the charging handle goes in. It all just depends on how good of a painter you are and how picky you are. Like, I painted the muzzle just in case I fuck up, and you know, just in case. A lot of you are probably like, Darius, why don't you take the barrel off and make it easier on yourself? Well, I got one word for you: laziness. That looks a lot better than the orange, in my personal opinion. Straight green, through and through. You can still see through the holes. Still straight through them. No orange spots. There might be a couple I need to touch up on. But overall, looks good. Give it 24 to 48 hours to dry.
So I give live updates on my Instagram. Go follow it. I'll link it up right here. I do reels that are pretty funny that aren't really my content, but I give credit because I'm not an asshole. I do like stories, so if you guys ever want to interact with me, go follow my Instagram. I'm not really active on Snapchat anymore. I'm mostly on Instagram throughout the day. So go ahead and follow that.
We're gonna go ahead and drench that in the rubbing alcohol and then paint the lower. This will be dry here in about 24 hours. It's touchable. It's looking really freaking good. I mean, really good.
You see multiple parts of this, like uploaded twice or something, like little bits and snippets. I'm gonna be uploading some parts as like how-tos, just because it'll help out getting traction in my channel, and I think a lot of people could use some of the advice that I learned, considering I'm new to all this a little bit. But just had some bacon, or not bacon, sausage and eggs. Yep, it's getting a little chilly out.
That's pretty much dry. I might have to go over that again, but it isn't that big of a deal. I mean, everything is bad. We watch the bands until the stars burn out the morning sky. You dragged me in, became the skin that keeps me warm at night. All that you left me was a number on the back of my hand. I kissed the poison on your lips till I was paralyzed. Now all the chemicals are burning right between my eyes. You left me was a number on the back of my.
Look, I got myself some black spray paint. Trying not to move my cord around too much. I got some black camo paint. Courtesy to Jake. We're gonna go ahead and paint the buttstock black and these two mags black. I got a 10 round mag and I just got a 30 round mag from Jake. We're gonna go ahead and paint them black. Kill the ammo out of there, paint them black. Wondering, I'm doing the same process. I'm just taking a piece of sandpaper, a little bit rougher than you want. You want really, really fine. This is thick. This is really thick. I might go hang another piece, but you're just sanding it, dipping it, dumping
rubbing alcohol, and you're painting it the color you want. It looks sexy. My God. We got a touch up back here. Ignore my sister, but we got a touch up under the trigger, under the magwell, and right here. Honestly, dude, I'm fucking loving this setup. I gotta put more tape back here. I'm on the trigger again. I'm gonna be taping this or end up just buying a new handguard. I haven't quite decided. We did end up painting, and it fell, but we ended up painting the stock black, and the black paint Jake got me is fucking empty. So what do you know? He had some extra from when he did his. And then we're just gonna paint the 30 round mag gray, because I think gray on green would look fucking lit. So should be done by Monday.
Stay tuned, follow my Instagram, links in the description. Try the merch, links in the description. Love you guys. Peace.